Today I want to explain about the nitrogen, estimation of nitrogen plants and protein content in the plant samples. Generally people estimate the nitrogen content and protein content by distillation method, simple distillation method. But it is taking a lot of time. And some people estimate with another colorimetric method also. But many people are telling this Nestle's reagent gives so many mistakes. It is erroneous. Some people tell it is only qualitative, not quantitative. But I made it absolutely quantitative by taking so many precautions. Here, first time I noticed this colorimetric test in Ogle's textbook. They try to estimate the nitrogen quantitatively. They gave procedure. But for our plant samples, that is not suitable. It is suitable only, but we have to make some modifications. Because our plant sample is having acidity, because we digest the sample with concentrated sulfuric acid, first we have to neutralize that sample. And how much sample we have to take? These are the things we have to keep in the mind. Here, in a higher concentration, we don't get nitrogen, accurate to nitrogen measurement. For accuracy, we have to dilute the sample. We have to dilute the sample 1600 times, means how it 1600 times I will tell. Here, first when we are digesting, we are taking 250 milligrams only. Some people take 1 gram sample, dried sample, some people take 500 milligrams, some people 250 milligrams. When you take 1 gram of them, 1 gram of sample, it will take 2 hours time for digestion. It is a lot of time it will take. So in order to reduce the time for digestion, we are taking very less amount, 250 milligrams. Then we can complete the digestion within 45 minutes. So here already we reduced the sample size. Even for 250 milligrams, if we dilute the sample, if we are taking 250 milligrams, 100 ml volumetric plus, after digestion, if we are making to 100 ml, from that, if you take 0.5 ml of the solution for developing color with Nestle's reagent, then also it is so high, and we don't get clear values, accurate values for estimating the nitrogen. So we have to dilute the samples. First we have to dilute the sample for 100 times. Again you take some 10 ml or 5 ml. Again you 4 times you dilute. Suppose if you take 5 ml, another 15 ml you add distilled water and make it as 4 times dilution. Like that, you have to dilute 1600 times. How it is 1600 times? If we are digestion sample 1 gram making 100 ml, it is 100 times. Instead of 1 gram, if you are taking 250 milligrams and dilute into 100 ml, it is 400 times. Here itself 400 times. Again that sample, 4 times if you are diluting, 1600 times dilution. So that sample you have to take for estimating the color in the spectrophotometer. Only that also only take 0.5 ml, half ml only. That 1600 times diluted sample, you take only half ml. Half ml of the sample you take and develop the color. You take into 25 ml volumetric plus. You take 0.5 ml of the 1600 times diluted sample and neutralize the acidity. with sodium hydroxide, 5% sodium hydroxide. First you take 0.5 ml of solution separately and add phenolphthalein and titrate and get some value. That much amount you have to add after adding 0.5 ml of the sample. That much sodium hydroxide you have to add in order to reduce that acidity. If you are having acidity in the sample, you cannot get color with natural reagent. It should be basic in the In the same way, in sample standards also, you have to maintain the same environment. When you are digesting, we are using digestion mixture, 1 gram digestion mixture. Accurately, we are measuring 1 gram of digestion mixture, each and every sample. So, in the standards also, we have to maintain the same spirit. Means, when we are that 1 gram of copper sulfate digestion mixture, potassium sulfate copper sulfate digestion mixture, it will be diluted 100 times 1 gram, and again 4 times it will be diluted. Means 400 times it will be diluted. 1 gram, if it is diluted 400 times, 1 by 400 grams will be there for 1 ml. But we are taking only 0.5 ml. Then how much it will be further, 800 times it will be reduced. Means in 1 gram, 1 by 800, how much? That much copper sulfate in digestion mixture will be there. That much we have to add in each and every standard. And acidity also, almost 10 ml of acid will be remaining, sulfuric acid. That much amount of acid also we maintain in the sample. So for that, we have to artificially we keep 10 ml of sulfuric acid, constant sulfuric acid, 1 gram of digestion mixture, and make it to 100 ml. Again, certain amount you take, and again 4 times you dilute. That 4 times diluted sample, you have to take 0.5 ml. The sample also you are taking 0.5 ml. Separately, you measure for 0.5 ml how much sodium hydroxide we have to add in order to neutralize. In the standards as well as sample also, you neutralize the samples with 5% sodium hydroxide and add sufficient amount of water, up to 20 ml of water you add. Then we add 1 ml of Nestle's reagent and make the volume to 25 ml. Then you shake it thoroughly and keep for 10 minutes and take the readings at to 625 nanometers. Here we are taking standards, one blank, another 10 milligrams, 10 micrograms, 20 micrograms, 30 micrograms, 40 micrograms, like that. Means we are taking 10 ppm nitrogen solution. If we add to 1 ml, it will give 10 micrograms nitrogen, 10 ppm, 1 ml. Like that, 1 ml, 2 ml, 3 ml, 4 ml, we'll get 10 micrograms, 20 micrograms, 30 micrograms, 40 micrograms nitrogen, each volumetric plus. So according to that, we prepare standard curve and we'll get the nitrogen in micrograms in each volumetric plus with a 0.5 ml of 1600 times diluted sample. Then that reading, you will get some reading from the graph, means 10 micrograms or 12 micrograms or 5 micrograms, whatever it may be. That will be multiplied with a factor 0.32 in order to get percent nitrogen in the sample. In this way, we can perfectly measure the nitrogen content of the sample. After measuring the nitrogen concentration, you multiply that nitrogen percent with 6.25, it will give protein content in the sample. This how we should measure the nitrogen and protein content in the sample by using Nestle's reagent.